So we are studying the role of financial institutions in support of women entrepreneurial activities. We have studied some of the schemes, and today we'll be going for RUDSETI. Okay, so what is that we will study? So we are dealing with the third unit. Here we have rural development scheme. And I have listed out the schemes like this. We have 9 out of that. We have studied SI, DBI, DIC, and CDOC we have studied. Now, today we'll be studying about Rural Development and Self-Employment Training Institute, RUDSETI. Okay. So, Rural Development and Self-Employment Training Institute, it is, the acronym for that is RUDSETI. And this is what is the Board of Governors of Rural Development and Self-Employment Training Institute. Okay, so what are these things? This will be studying. Now, we will just go for the background. Why was this instituted? Why was this training institute started? That will be studying. You see, lakhs of youth are entering the job market every year in this country, but are unable to find suitable employment. Non-availability of adequate employment opportunities in the organized and unorganized sectors is one of the serious challenges the country is facing. In such a scenario, the need for promoting self-employment for the unemployed youth, for the unemployment rural youth, particularly those below the poverty line, and periodic skill upgradation to keep them abreast of latest technologies need to be overstated. Once trained appropriately, the youth will launch profitable micro enterprises and enhance their own standards of living and thereby contribute to the overall nation economy, national economy. They can also feed the service sectors both within the country and abroad. So as a background, every year many of them are getting graduated. Many youths are getting graduated. And it is not true that everybody will get a job. Everybody is not getting job. There are jobs in the country, but the number of people who are being graduated are more in number. And moreover, everybody do not have the opportunity to move about everywhere and try to go for such skills. It is not possible. So what the government has thought is to organize an institute where especially the rural youths are trained, rural youths, and they are of below poverty line. Andre artha enu illi government en vichar martu every year bhalashtu jana graduate aagi horag bartaru avaru ellargu jobs sigadu kashta adu. It's very difficult to get the jobs. ಅವಾಗ ಏನಾಗ್ತದ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಈಗ ಸಿಟಿ ಒಳಗೆ ಇರೋರು ಪ್ಯಾರಲಲ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಏನಾದ್ರೂ ಸ್ಕಿಲ್ ಡೆವಲಪ್ ಮಾಡಿರ್ತಾರೆ. ಬಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದ ರೂರಲ್ ಪೀಪಲ್? ಇಟ್ಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಡಿಫಿಕಲ್ಟ್. ಅಂಡ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದಿ ಬಿಲೋ ಪಾವರ್ಟಿ ಲೈನ್ ಪೀಪಲ್? ಇಟ್ಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಡಿಫಿಕಲ್ಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ದೆಮ್ ಟು ಗೆಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಾ ಸ್ಕಿಲ್ಸ್. ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ಈಗ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ನೀವು ಒಂದು ಟ್ಯಾಲಿ ಕೋರ್ಸ್ ಹೋಗ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಟ್. ಸೊ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಬಡು ಇರೋರು ಅದನ್ನ ಕೊಡ್ಲಿಕ್ ಆಗ್ಲಿಕ್ಕಿಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಗೌರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತು ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಸ್ಪೆಷಲಿ ಫಾರ್ ರೂರಲ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಬಿಪಿಎಲ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಬಿಲೋ ಪಾವರ್ಟಿ ಲೈನ್. ಯು ಸಿ ರೂರಲ್ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಎಂಪ್ಲಾಯ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಟ್ರೈನಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಟ್, ಈ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಟ್ ಅನ್ನ ಸೆಟಪ್ ಮಾಡ್ತು. ವೈ ದಿಸ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಟ್? ಎದಕ್ಕಂತಂದ್ರೆ ರೂರಲ್ ಯೂತ್ಗೆ ಸ್ಪೆಷಲಿ ಫಾರ್ ಟ್ರೈನಿಂಗ್ ದ ರೂರಲ್ ಯೂತ್, ಅವರಿಗೆ ಟ್ರೈನಿಂಗ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟು ಅವ್ರ ಸ್ಕಿಲ್ ಅಪ್ಗ್ರೇಡೇಷನ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ಎದಕ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು? ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಅವ್ರು ತಾವಾಗೆ ಒಂದ್ ಏನಾದ್ರೂ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಎಂಪ್ಲಾಯ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ತಾವಾಗೆ ಒಂದು ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು. ಮೈಕ್ರೋ ಎಂಟರ್ಪ್ರೈಸ್, ದೊಡ್ಡ ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಇರ್ಲಿಕ್ಕಿಲ್ಲ, ಸಣ್ಣದೇ ಒಂದ್ ಏನಾದ್ರೂ. ಯು ಸಿ ಹಿಯರ್, ಮೈಕ್ರೋ ಎಂಟರ್ಪ್ರೈಸಸ್, ಸಣ್ಣದ ಒಂದು ಎಂಟರ್ಪ್ರೈಸ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ತಾವೇ ಒಂದ್ ಏನಾದ್ರೂ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಅಥವಾ ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರಿ, ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರೀಸ್, ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ತಮ್ ತಾವೇ ಒಂದು ಚಲೋ ಲೈಫ್ ಕೊಡ್ಬೋದು ತಮಗೆ ತಮ್ಮ ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿಗೆ. ನಾಟ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ದಟ್, they also contribute towards the economic development of the country. Okay, so the government of India is already implementing the Swarna Jayanti, Gram Swarojgar Yojana, SGSY, aimed at providing sustainable income to rural BPL families, largely through the process of formation of self-help groups that are provided with credit linkage with banks and subsidy for creation of income generating assets so as to bring them above the poverty line. However, due to the lack of necessary skills for undertaking particular enterprises and also their lack of capacity to access the formal occasional training institutions, due to the lack of basic entry qualifications, it is difficult for BPL youth to take up any trade for self-employment. Even if they are already engaged in some trade, they need some hand-holding in the form of periodic doses of skill upgradation training for making their initiative viable and sustainable in an increasingly competitive world. All of you know that nowadays there's a lots of competition. Okay, there is a lots of competition and youth are getting trained, and most of the times what is happening is some of them are not even getting the graduations. The below poverty line youth, they are unable to complete their graduation. So what is happening? They are not getting a perfect job or perfect skills for self-development. So the government has started many schemes to help the rural youth, especially BPL students, to overcome and upgrade their skills. With the aim of mitigating the unemployment problem among the youth, a new initiative was tried jointly by Sri Dharmasthala Manjunatheshwara Educational Trust, Syndicate Bank and Canara Bank in 1982, which was the setting up of Rural Development and Self-Employment Training Institute with its acronym RUDSETI, Root City, near Dharmasthala in Karnataka. Several centers of RUDSETI are already operating successfully now. So, ivnella consider maadi Dharmasthala Institution, Syndicate Bank and Canara Bank. Together, they have started this Rural Development and Self-Employment Training Institutions in 1982. It is located near Dharmasthala and many other centers are successfully operating. However, there is an urgent need for upscaling the operations in this area, keeping in view the mammoth requirements in the country. Minister of Rural Development, MORD, is convinced that there is a need for dedicated structure to ensure necessary skill upgradation in the rural BPL youth. Since the RUDSETI has today become a replicable model, the MORD purposes to support establishment of an RUDSETI type of institution in each district of the country to tap the rural BPL youth from the rural hinterland. These will be bank-led institutions, that is, will be managed and run by public sector, private sector banks with an active cooperation from the state government. So, Ministry of Rural Development, what it did is, it identified this RUDSETI, its operations, and it encouraged every district to develop this type of institute so that it is helpful to train, to build up the confidence among the rural youth, especially rural BPL youth. The youth are young and below poverty line irthare avrige upgradation, skill upgradation madlike tamde ondu own institution set madkolike, institution in the sense any type of business set madkolike, help madlike they have encouraged this type of institutions. Amele ee institution is run by public sector and private sector banks. Like this is the Dharmasthala Institution is a private sector, Syndicate Bank and Canara Bank. Together, they have started this training institutions. RUDSETI score offering includes its free, unique, and intensive short residential self-employment training programs with free food, accommodation, and design specially for rural youth. ಇದು ಹಳ್ಳಿ ಜನಗಷ್ಟೇ ಡಿಸೈನ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದದ. ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಫ್ರೀ, ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಯುನೀಕ್ ಟೈಪ್, ಅಂಡ್ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಇಂಟೆನ್ಸಿವ್ ಶಾರ್ಟ್ ಟರ್ಮ್ ಕೋರ್ಸಸ್ ರೆಸಿಡೆನ್ಷಿಯಲ್. ಅವ್ರು ಬಂದು ಎಲ್ಲಿರ್ಬೇಕು, ನೀವು ಸಿಟಿ ಒಳಗೆ ಕಂಡಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ವೇರ್ ದೇ ಶುಡ್ ಸ್ಟೇ, ಸೊ ರೆಸಿಡೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಇಸ್ ಫ್ರೀ, ಫ್ರೀ ಆಫ್ ಫುಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಅಕಾಮಡೇಷನ್. ಓಕೆ, ಅನದರ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಫೀಚರ್ ಆಫ್ RUDSETIs ಈಸ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ವಿಷನ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್, ವಿಚ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಶಿಯೇಟ್ಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದಿ ನಾರ್ಮಲ್ ರನ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಮಿಲ್ ಒಕೇಶನಲ್ ಟ್ರೈನಿಂಗ್ ಸೆಂಟರ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಎಸ್ಟಾಬ್ಲಿಷ್ಡ್ ದೆಮ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಯುನಿಕ್ ಬ್ರ್ಯಾಂಡ್. All these are proposed to be replicated in the RUDSETI type of institutions to be aided by GUI. Okay, what are its objectives, that we'll see. Now rural RUDSETI type of institutions aided by GUI, Government of India, will therefore have the following objectives. What are its objectives? The trainings offered will be demand driven. Andre yav course ge demand ada adannashte training kodtare. Now for example, sanitizer is much in demand, so they'll give training in how to manufacture a sanitizer. So whatever is in demand, current trend, such trainings will be offered to those youth. Rural BPL youth will be given high priority. Especially rural PPL students are given high priority. Area in which training will be provided to a particular rural BPL youth will be decided after assessment of aptitude of the candidate. Ella rural youth ku hogi kodangila enantada, they may misuse it. Alli hogi uta siktada irlik siktada sumne eno training attend aagi baradalla. So what they are doing is, before taking the admission, before taking the training, they are taking one aptitude test. So aptitude test, it will tell you the intention of that particular person, the intelligence, thinking aptitude, that they will judge. Hand holding will be provided for assured credit linkage with the banks. Bank inda loan kodlike adu help madu. Escort services will be provided for ensuring at least 2-year follow-up to ensure sustainability of micro enterprise undertaken by the rural BPL youth. Our training kutmale, the BPL youth are trained first and then they help them to start a micro enterprise. Okay, so after that they follow up for 2 years continuously, so that that enterprise is set up or not, any difficulties again there are there to help. Ella training aadmele avrige loan kodsi 2 varsha tana follow up martare, so that they stand up in a particular line, any problems bandurnu again they are ready to help. Provide intensive short term residential self employment training programs with free food and accommodation to rural youth for taking up self-employment initiatives and skill up accreditation for running their micro enterprises successfully. Intensive short term courses, continuous agi short term courses, intensive antandre forcefully with lots of informations, and very nicely the short term training courses are conducted specially for self-employment. Self-employment andre tamde ondu own enterprise sannadeya kagirli tamde ondu own business setup madlike help martare. It is, the trainings are with free of cost, free food and free accommodation specially for rural BPL students. So these are the objectives of RUDSETI. So while seeking to establish the RUDSETI type institutions, the Ministry of Rural Development is fully conscious of the uniqueness of the RUDSETIs with their distinctive set of values, ethos and culture, and insists that the RSETIs that are going to be established under the present scheme shall conform to the values of the RUDSETI. The Government of India has recognized that the principal reason behind the success of The RUDSETI model is unflinching commitment of the sponsors to the cause of youth development and scheme that the same shall continue in RSETIs that are going to be established under the new scheme as well. Antandre RUDSETI is specially a Karnataka government scheme. So same government of India is also trying to institute this type of training institutions throughout the country, district level. So it ensures that the same values and same quality of this are followed in every particular institutions. We'll see the objectives. Empower rural youth and economically backward sections, leading to the development of rural enterprise and entrepreneurship. Same thing I repeated here. Identify, orient, motivate, train, and assist rural youth, including tribal communities, to attain sustainability and economic well-being through rural entrepreneurship. Upgrade technical, agricultural, managerial, and service delivery skills. Promote and train self-help groups. Identify, develop, transfer appropriate and sustainable rural technologies. Personality development for school and college students. Promote awareness and trigger use of non-conventional and energy efficient technologies. These are the main objectives. Enu antandre empower, give them lots of power, empower the rural BPL youths for what? For developing their own enterprises. Avrude ondu sonta enterprise business start madidru antandre they are having a good living, they can make a good living for themselves, for those who are to whom they are giving employment. They are contributing towards the development of the country. For this, they identify the people, the youths who are well knowledgeable, who are well interested, and train them. They also pick up the students from tribal areas. They are also very good, and they train them in rural technology only, in rural, in their village only. Whatever they get, with that they give lots of training and demand oriented training. Demand andre yav product jaasti adala adr malene training kodtaru, and also they follow up to attain sustainability and economic well being. Okay, upgrade technical, agricultural and managerial skills. That means they upgrade the rural youth with the new technologies, new type of agriculture. They can do managerial skills, delivery skills, marketing skills. Promote and train self-help groups. There are self-help groups. They promote them, they train them. Identify, develop and transfer appropriate sustainable rural technologies. Villages olage bahalashtu technologies you can develop. They identify such things. If agriculture is there, they identify that, and technically they help them to develop that one only. Personality development, that is very much important. Personality development for school and college level, there only they will train them how to be an entrepreneurship, how to be self independent, how to get the training in technology, how to understand the real world, how to behave there. Everything is taught in schools and colleges. These are the objectives. Okay, then promote awareness and trigger use of non conventional and energy efficient technologies. Okay, now what is the eligibility criteria for training? To whom they can give training? Any unemployed youth in the age group of 18 to 45 years, he should be a youth. Okay, irrespective of caste, creed, religion, gender and economic status, having aptitude to take up self employment or wage employment, and having some basic knowledge in the related field, can undergo training which is totally free. Training is given which is totally free, free of food, free of accommodation. Okay, not only that, they are helping with loans. Ishtella madid mele who can take the training? Sumne yarnu hogi training tagolak sadde illa. ದಿ ಅನ್ಎಂಪ್ಲಾಯ್ಡ್ ಯೂತ್ ಅವರಿಗೆ ಜಾಬ್ ಇರಬಾರ್ದು ಅಂತವರು ಅನ್ಎಂಪ್ಲಾಯ್ಡ್ ರೂರಲ್ ಯೂತ್ ಓಕೆ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ರೀಡ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟಸ್ ಜೆಂಡರ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಇಸ್ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ಡ್ ಎನಿಬಡಿ ಇವನ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಟ್ರೈನಿಂಗ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಏಜ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ 18 to 45 years ಅಂಡ್ ಅಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದಟ್ ಯು ಶುಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸರ್ಟನ್ ಟ್ಯಾಲೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ನಿಮ್ದೇ ನೀವು ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಅದು ಮುಂದುವರೆಸೋ ಟ್ಯಾಲೆಂಟ್ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಹತ್ರ ಇರಬೇಕು ಓಕೆ ಸಚ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಐಡೆಂಟಿಫೈಡ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಆಪ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಡ್ ಟೆಸ್ಟ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ವಿನ್ ಇನ್ ದಟ್ ದೆನ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಟೇಕನ್ ಫಾರ್ ಟ್ರೈನ್ ಓಕೆ that unique selling program that is USP of RUDSETI what is uniqueness in this training visionary leadership provided by Dr. D. Virendra Hegde supported by two leading nationalized bank syndicate and Canara Bank now these two have merged and now it is only Canara Bank all of you know this I think free training with food and accommodation the uniqueness of this training program we are seeing here free training for with free food and accommodation short term training with long term follow escort services for a period of 2 years training kotmale follow up martare for 2 years campus approach with unique training methodology unique training new methods are used for training excellent facilities for hands on training ಬಹಳಷ್ಟು ಫೆಸಿಲಿಟೀಸ್ ಕೊಡ್ತಾರಲ್ಲಿ ನಿಮ್ ಟ್ರೈನಿಂಗ್ ಕೊಡ್ಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ವೆರೈಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಟ್ರೈನಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್ಸ್ ಟು ಸೂಟ್ ದ ಲೋಕಲ್ ನೀಡ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಲ್ಲೇ ನೀವು ಏನ್ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಲ್ಲ ದಟ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಯೂಸ್ಫುಲ್ ದೇರ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಮಾರ್ಕೆಟೇಬಲ್ ಇನ್ ದಟ್ ಏರಿಯಾ ಓನ್ಲಿ ದ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಯು ಡೂ ದ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಯು ಮ್ಯಾನುಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಚರ್ ದಟ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಸೇಲೆಬಲ್ ಇನ್ ದಟ್ ಏರಿಯಾ ಓನ್ಲಿ okay it should be of much higher demand in that area then only you can market your products and you will be more profitable variety of training programs to okay local needs then practical orientation rigorous training and extended hours of learning practical orientation antandre neve en training kodtiralla it should be practically oriented then only you can understand if it is only theory you cannot understand practical oriented approach will be there for that particular training so next one past trainees become trainers and impart training already those who have taken training will come back and give training for the new youths high settlement rate 70% of trained youths 70% of the trained youths have already settled down so the success percentage is 70% the youths who have started micro enterprises are earning in a range of 2500 to 30000 per month it is a very good amount for the rural BPL students youth I can say in good number of cases the earning has crossed 15000 per month aur inno jaasti adru work maadi they have come forward and they are earning 50000 per month now employment generation by settled trainees in the range of 1 to 50 persons okay so these are the uniqueness of the RUDSETI's program okay what is a training methodology identification and selection of a right candidate for the right course okay the youths they are selected they are taking aptitude test some interviews they will take after that they will understand which person has interest in what type of course what type of business he can do or in which area he is staying in that area what is much in demand they select identify select and give training in that area only campus and practical approach will be there they don't say theoretically they give them practical knowledge they take to the field and give the training use of simulation exercises group discussions role plays during the training period group discussion role play discussions everything will be there field visit and experience sharing with role models fields karkond hogtar field antandre where there is a manufacturing unit if it is agriculture they take to that particular field along with some successful persons and they explain it from them interactions with bankers and government officials. This is very much important because you need loans. So bankers will guide you how you can take the loan, how you can approach. Then when you set up an industry, small itself, so you need to know what are the permissions and what are the rules and regulations of the government. So all continuous interactions with the bankers and government officials will be conducted. This is the training methodology. And this institution, what type of recognition it has got? Received FICCI award for rural development in the year 1998-99. Received national level SIDBI award for the distinguished services to the MSME sector for the year 10-11. Received Suvarna Karnataka Rajyotsava award for social service for the year 6-7. Recognizing the efforts of RUD SETI in rural entrepreneurship development, Ministry of Rural Development has given Executive Director RUD SETI as member in Central Level Coordination Committee meeting on SGSY, CLCC, National Council for Strengthening of Self-Help Groups Movement, Committee on Credit-Related Issues under SGSY and other national committee, national level committees. RUD SETI trained women entrepreneurs for have excelled by winning national award instituted by IMM NABARD consistently. Shri KC Amin, past trainee of our RUD SETI, Brahmamar and Srimati Doretta Christabella, past trainee of RUD SETI Bangalore, received Citibank Best Entrepreneur Award for the years 2007-8 and 8-9 respectively. Shri Prakash Dasanoth, past trainee of RUD SETI Dharwad, has bagged prestigious Bharati Entrepreneur Year Award 2008 instituted by EDII Ahmedabad. So I have read out all these things. What is this? This is their recognition, means they have received so many awards. The institution has received for training the rural youth, for training women entrepreneurs, for giving them a living, making them successful. Not only that, the RUD's SETI trained persons have also received the award. They have reached to a higher level. This is the recognition of the institutions. So what are the training programs? RUD SETI offers more than 60 types of entrepreneurship development programs, 60 types in various avenues. All the programs are of short duration, intervention ranging from 1 to 6 weeks. Mainly they are classified into four categories as shown below. 60 programs are there, all are short term, no long term courses, 1 to 6 weeks, that's all. So that what they want is give the training and immediately let them start their work. Even as bankers are included, even loans are provided to them very easily. So these are mainly divided into two, and within that again we have classification. What are those? First generation entrepreneurs, agriculture EDP and product EDPs, and you have one more, two more, process EDPs and general EDP. So what is this agriculture EDP? Commercial horticulture, floriculture, krishi udyami, dairy farming and vermicompost making, poultry, beekeeping, pesiculture, vegetable nursery management, cultivation, poly houses, shed net farming, piggery, sheep rearing, cultivation of medicinal and aromatic plants, rubber tapping, processing, gardening, landscaping, etc. Agriculture related EDPs. Okay, so the few days back I told you about the mango seed saplings. So that is also a type of training. Like you saw that YouTube, it's a training for you. I don't know how many of you have already done it. I have done around 15. Okay, till now I have done around 15, and that is the seed has given up, sprouted up very nicely. And shortly I'll be getting plants also. I'll put a photo of that and I'll show you. Like this, they are training the rural youth in that agriculture field only. What they can do, what extra they can do in their lands. what they can do in their rural areas. See, the vermicompost, you don't need much of the land over there. That is the organic compost you are preparing for vegetables and agricultural lands. Poultry is there, beekeeping. There are so many such things, agriculture oriented, that all training is given in all these things. Product EDPs, women's and men's tailors, homemade agarbatti makers, soft toys makers and sellers, embroidery, fabric painting, jute products, udyami, costume jewelry, papad, pickle, masala powder, candle making, bamboo, cane craft, etc. First one is agriculture making, second one is products, any type of products. I told you in rural, tailoring is there, papad, pickle, masala powder is totally common. Still they are making and still they are in demand. Okay, bags you can make, embroideries you can make, all such trainings are given to the youth. Process EDPs, this include electric motor rewinding and repair services, beauty parlor management, photography, videography, cell phone repairs and service, okay, two wheelers, okay, Karelu, Vidyut, Upakarana Seva, Udyami, two wheeler machine entrepreneurship, desktop publishing, computer hardware networking, refrigeration and air conditioning, computerized accounting, men's parlor and saloon, installation and servicing of CCTV camera, security alarm and smoke detector, fast food stall, plumbing, sanitary works, travel and tourist guide, etc. Process EDPs. You see, so many are there. Trainings are given in all of these things. Any of the training you can take. General EDPs, entrepreneurship development program for micro entrepreneurs, business correspondents, business facilitators, debt recovery agents, PMEGP beneficiaries, financial literacy, bank mitra, shopkeeper, etc. Okay, so these are the various areas where training is given. Okay, next is for established entrepreneurs. First one was those who want to start it at the first. Now already there are entrepreneurs and how you want to train them. Skill upgradation, to improve the skill upgradation skills and enhance capability of the settled trainings. Already you have given skill to them, training to them. So now you are giving, enhancing their skills so that they can still proceed forward. Growth programs to aim and achieve high goals in life and business for settled trainings. Aim high, okay, they have already settled, they have come to a certain level. Now you are giving them training to still proceed further and become more successful in that area where they are trained and already doing the business. RUDACTI institutes also organize EDPs, that is entrepreneurship development programs for transgender members, jail inmates, persons with disability and sex workers. All the courses are National Skill Qualification Framework aligned courses, approved by National Skills Qualification Committee, and 4 EDP courses notified by Ministry of Rural Development. Any type of persons, everybody who are in need, who don't have their own funds to take the skills, who are in rural areas, remote areas, all such people are selected and given training so that they can improve. So each of the institution proposed to be set up under the scheme should conform to certain basic standards. While there are minimum standards, the sponsoring banks may decide to establish superior facilities based on their own corporate culture and philosophy. The Government of India will meet the one-time expenditure of the establishment of such basic infrastructure up to the amounts indicated subsequently. The last topic of this is administration of the institution and standards. How the administration is, what is the infrastructure, how the trainees are, just we'll see it in very shortly. Standards in infrastructure, common minimum infrastructure, 2 to 3 classrooms with toilet facilities separate for women and physically challenged friendly. 2 workshops, 2 dormitories with bath and toilet facilities, 1 kitchen and 1 dining hall, one director's room, one administrative room, one storeroom, two guest rooms, three staff quarters, including one of the director, and two for maintenance staff of the institute, one reception counter, and one common room with basic amenities. Okay, so the infrastructure of that institutions we are seeing here. Everything that is required for a training institute, school or college is here in this institution. Contents. What are the course contents over here? The type of training programs would have to be decided by the institute based on the local resource situation and the potential demand for the products and services. The advice of the LSE would be very essential in this regard. A uniform standardized curriculum would be developed and circulated among the institutions. The nodal agencies for developing curriculum for the training would be RUDACTI, UGIRE, who will undertake this task in consultation with NIRD Hyderabad. There shall be two sets of training curriculums as shown below. Basic orientation program courses for SGSY and SHG, self-help groups and cell groups. Skill development programs for micro enterprise and wage employment placement. Soft skill training shall be integral part of all the training programs. Course contents, whatever it is. Now, for example, women entrepreneurship subject, if the course content is decided, there is a BOS committee. Okay. Scheme of studies, we say. For that, there is a committee. The university appoints a committee, makes a committee, and give them work to make this course content. Similarly, in these institutions also, courses are designed in such a way that they help the youth in a very practical way, so that directly they can go out and start their own business. And it is not a course of 1 year, 2 years, 3 years. No lengthy courses, short-term courses. So the content should be such that within 1 week, you should be able to start your own business. 1 week to 6 months. Sorry, 6 weeks. That is, within 1.5 months, you are a trained beautician and you have to start your own beauty parlor. Such is the content of this course. Size of the batch. So each batch, you cannot take hundreds of students. It is 25 to 30 candidates. Okay. And Shramadhan Yoga, presentation of most important lessons learned yesterday shall become the integral part of the training program. Next one is sponsoring of applications. It shall be primary responsibility of all DRDAs and the branches of the sponsoring bank to sponsor the rural BPL trainees, other bank branches, government departments operating in the area. District manager of the district industries center, ITDAs, NYKs, etc. should be motivated to sponsor the candidates. Progress of sponsoring of applications should be discussed in all BLBC, DCC, DLRC meeting, and director of RSETI shall be invariable present, attend all the meetings. Okay, sponsoring of applications. And now you see many of them will give the applications, but most of them are there who do not know about all these things. Now, you only never knew what is this RUDACTI. You might now start thinking that you also can take the training. So how to apply, how these applications are accepted. So there is a complete structure over here, how they are accepted. Selection of trainings, at least 70% of the training should be from the rural BPL category, 70%. Other anybody can apply. Okay. Such time the DRDA certifies that the BPL list of the particular district is exhausted. Proper weightage as per SGSY guidelines shall be given to the candidates belonging to weaker section like SCSTs, minorities, physically handicapped, and women. Follow up, proper system for regular follow up hand holding of trainees should be put in place for a minimum period of 2 years. This you have been studying. So next one is training trainers training program, TTPs. trainers training program for the directors of the RACTIs and the faculties will be conducted at regular intervals by apex organizations like NIRD and RUDACTI, UGIRE, banks shall ensure that officers posted as directors undergo TTPs before taking charge of RACTIs or at the earliest possible to instill in them the training competencies as well as the value of RACTI. So it is not that only students are trained, even teachers are trained. Similarly, we also will have training programs. We do also have FDPs, that is faculty development programs. Similarly, in these institutions also, if you are going there to teach something, you are given training. If you are going as a director, again you are given training. So that all the objectives and rules of these institutions are followed correctly and executed in a perfect manner. Evaluation of RACTIs, NIRD, or any other agency nominated by Ministry of Rural Development on behalf of the Government of India will take up the responsibility of monitoring the progress of each RACTI at periodical intervals. Beside LNM teams may also take up task of monitoring the performance of RACTI. Okay, evaluation, continuous evaluation should be there. We take exams for you, test for you, what is that? That is continuous evaluation. Not only that, we also need feedback from you, how we take the classes. If you don't get the feedbacks, we will never know whether we are teaching correctly or not, whether you all are understanding, whether I should change or not. So evaluation is required for each and every person, not only students, for teachers also. Credit linkage, assistance in credit linking of trainees by sending the list of candidates to bank branches and coordinating with them for extending financial assistance under SGSY and any other government sponsored scheme or direct lending will be the responsibility of the director RACTI. He shall also ensure that the list of candidates is sent to all bank branches of the area and coordinate with them for availing financial assistance under any government sponsored scheme or direct lending. Arranging periodical interactive meets for ex-trainees involving bank branches to enable the trainees to overcome their problems in availing bank credit would be another feature. So what these training institutes will do is, they send a list of all the youth who have taken training to these banks. They send their list and they only start the process of giving them the loans. Okay. Next, recognition of RACTI trainees certificate issue. So you complete your BCom, you get a degree. Similarly, for all these trainers, they give the certificate so that they are recognized and further it is helpful for their future. Innovative programs, next one. So innovative, new types of programs are included in this training. So new type of programs in the sense, every time the taste changes, you have studied, the consumers goes on changing, they demand for new type of products. Whenever the demand for new product exists, such trainings are given to the trainers over here. Skill upgradation programs. As you all know that technology is moving very, very fast. So giving knowledge about the soft skills and technology is very important. So continuous upgradation of technology will be given to the trainers. Women empowerment. Okay. Yeah. RACTI should give equal opportunities for women entrepreneurs. It is possible to cite a number of examples where women-led enterprises have achieved success. Therefore, RACTIs could organize exclusive programs for women in various trades depending upon their attitudes and local demand. Women empowerment. More opportunities are given to women. Interface to create a wide network of people connected with rural development activity. It will be necessary to organize NGO banker, government official banker, industrial banker interface meetings on micro enterprise promotion, identification of market trends and opportunities, etc. Such interfaces should be held at least twice or thrice annually at RSETIs and should be separately budgeted. What does this mean? Interface means, in more simple way, I can say a WhatsApp group is created of all those persons who have already taken training, they are into enterprise, they have settled up in their business, and now you are a trainee, so you can interact with them. Okay, they will guide you. There is an interaction with you and the bankers, with you and the government officials. Interface is there. They create a platform where you can contact each of the important person, and you, they will help you in all the ways to set up your enterprise. Okay. So these are the things what you have studied about this. Administration of institution and standards, how the administration runs and what are the standards that are set for RUD SETI. So today we have studied about the Rural Development Self-Employment Training Institute, RUD SETI. Okay, this is the Karnataka government. These are the board of governors that are recently appointed. Okay, clear about this? So in the next class we'll be going for the next one, that is State Financial Corporation. Today we'll end it here. Okay, thank you. So before that, all of you